Smallholder farmers make up approximately 89% of Uganda's farming population and produce up to 80% of the nation's total agriculture output. Despite their crucial role, these smallholder farmers, especially those in last mile communities, often face significant challenges in accessing modern farming equipment, machinery, and digital resources to enhance their productivity. Furthermore, there is a disconnect between such farmers' mode of operation and technological advancements being channeled out by several innovators across the value chain. This digital divide continues to hamper their productivity and limits their ability to fully contribute to the country's economic growth and improve their standard of living.
We are targeting smallholder farmers who make some money from their farm. If you're having one to three acres of land and you're making money from that farm, those are the kinds of farmers we are targeting. Are you in a farming group? Are you 25? Are you on a farmer production? Are you a cooperative? You can access this information. You can be carded as a farmer. So you should be able to go to ask Hamwe.
These were speaking during this year's 30th edition of the annual National Agricultural Show in Jinja under the theme Innovating Pathways to Farm Business-Led Agro-Industrialization. This year's edition was aimed at showcasing innovation solutions in the form of products or services that farmers can integrate into their farming practices to improve productivity and access vital information such as weather forecasts, market prices, and best farming practices.
Over the past 2.5 years, we've been implementing the Digital Economy Program, which is a collaboration between our partners, the MasterCard Foundation, and MasterCard Inc. What is unique about the Digital Economy Program, we are leveraging technology to bring services closer to last mile communities. Talk of a farmer who is not visible to different service providers. In this country, there are locations where we don't have access to grid, talk of electricity and other services like internet. So how do they participate in the digital economy? They need to sell whatever they've produced. They need to add value to the produce that they have produced. And even then, how do we track the change in their livelihood?
According to the Minister of Science, Technology and Innovation, Monica Musenero, the successful integration of technology in last-mile agricultural communities requires the collaboration of various stakeholders, including government, agencies, non-government organizations, private sector players, and local communities.
So my challenge now, they have taken the first lane. They have taken it from idea to market. Now we need to ask the next questions, and those were the questions I was posing to them. One, if we are serving farmers, what's the purpose? The purpose is not just to make a farmer use an app. Now we have to think, is the farmer making money? Because the overall goal is to help the farmer to earn better money, to help the farmer to make sure that they know where they are making money and where they are not making money, so that they can optimize farming now as a business. Because we're always talking about commercial agriculture. Now most of the farmers they are dealing with are small scale farmers. They are small households. They are enterprises which make money.
The minister commended the Innovation Village for the initiative, highlighting that the future of Ugandan agriculture lies in the hands of these resilient farmers, and with the right support, they can lead the way towards a more prosperous and technologically advanced agricultural landscape.